So now we are doing section 71C schedule 1. Section 71C is activities performed without consideration in the course of business. Majorly it is based on ITC concept of input tax credit. Activities are given in schedule 1. There are 4 activities. Abbreviation that we created was PERI. P was permanent transfer or disposal of business asset. Principal to agent, agent to principal. Then there is a related party transaction or distinct party, in that employee is there up to 50,000 rupees, exception is there. And then last one is import of service from related party without consideration but in the course of business. So those are that schedule they have copied here. You can see this schedule, okay? And these activities are there, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, based on that we are going to discuss some question now. Mr. Z Limited upgrades the computer system. The existing computers and laptop which do not support the upgraded version donated to trust. So what has happened here, you understood, no?
Yes.
One IT company there, which like these laptops are outdated now, so they donated to one trust. Donated means given without consideration. Is it a supply of service? Yes. Because it is covered under para 1 of schedule 1 of section 71C. This is permanent disposal. Permanent transfer of business asset on which ITC was taken. On which?
ITC.
ITC. So I'm reading this. This amounts to permanent transfer of business asset. The same will be treated as supply. Are you getting this? It is not supply, but it will be treated as supply. That means deemed supply. Okay? Treated as supply and liable to GST in the hands of Z Limited, provided if the company availed input tax credit on such computer. So this condition is very important. ITC has to be claim, then only it is treated as supply. If question says ITC did not claim or ITC was not claim on this computer, then it is not supply. The game is on ITC. In schedule 1, the whole game is on ITC. Okay? I hope you understood that example. Yeah? Very important. Mark it important and read it again when you are going home and then revise it. Message Shankar Private Limited, being a trader in clothes, permanently transfer 50% of stock to society at free of cost. What is the problem to income tax department is this. He is selling 50% of his stock to society. Given. Charitable. Dayawan. Hello.
Yes.
But problem is that he must have taken 100% input tax credit.
Yes.
So our issue is this. Because you are transferring business assets on which you have taken ITC, this 50% charity will be treated as supply and you need to pay tax. Then he asked me doubt, sir, if it is given without consideration, then how can we pay tax? So on open market value. On market value, we know, no, every goods have some market value. That valuation rules will decide. In this case, transfer of business stock would amount to supply if company had availed input tax credit. This is the answer part. Okay. That is the question part, this is the answer part. Okay. Next. Mr. Das purchased a car for personal use. Personal use. Did he take ITC?
No.
No. So if he transfer personal car, will it become taxable?
No.
No. Alright. And after he has sold it to dealer for 2 lakh, will the transaction be supply?
No. No.
Why? Because selling car is not his business.
Yes.
Hello? It might be for consideration. It is for consideration. 2 lakh rupees. But is it his business?
No.
No. Therefore, it is not taxable under 71C or supply. It's not supply under 71C. Okay. Can I go ahead?
Yes.
Yeah. It's not in the nature of supply, not in the course of business. Rahim purchased a car for business use, but after 2 years transferred the car for personal consumption to use at home. Will the transaction will be supplied? So he look at this, ITC not available. This note is given. Logic I will teach you in section 17.5. On car we don't get ITC. So ITC not available. But business asset transferred to personal asset. Now you tell me. Is it supply or not a supply? Not a supply. Why? But sir, it is permanent transfer. It is a permanent transfer of business asset, but on this ITC was not availed. So there won't be any GST on supply. Are you getting this?
Yes.
I told you, now the whole game is on ITC. ITC availed, then it is supply. ITC not availed, it is not supply. Very simple. ITC availed, it will be treated as deemed supply. ITC not availed, it will not be treated as supply. Okay? So this is also important, mark it. Okay, revise it later on. Messrs. M.N. Company, a sole proprietor, is in the business of selling furniture. Very good. Its owner took a set of furniture to furnish his house permanently. So business asset is taking home.
Yes.
Is it supply?
Yes.
Without consideration. He himself makes furniture, some furniture he takes to home. Is it a supply? Yes. Why? Because when he purchased that raw material for making furniture, he must have taken ITC. Yes or no? Now he is taking to home. That is wrong. Why ITC was given? Because you should use that asset in the business. Now you are using for personal purpose. Wrong. Therefore, 71C. Schedule 1 will apply, permanent transfer of business asset. Here it is not. If it is written here, ITC is not available, not availed, then he don't have to put tax on supply. Yes or no? ITC availed, taxable. ITC not availed, not taxable. Look at the answer. No, the transfer of furniture without consideration is not a supply of goods because credit is not allowed on personal consumption of business. You understand under section 17, subsection 5. So credit was not availed. If credit was not availed, then it is not supply. I did not see this line. If credit is availed, then it is supply. Okay, very simple. Credit availed, it is supply. Credit not availed, it is not a supply. Next. 41. T Limited is in the business of hotel. He purchased AC for business purpose and after 2 years, he transferred AC to director without consideration. Business asset transferred. Now, see, AC availed, ITC on AC is availed. So, what will happen now? It will be treated as supply. Why? Because, sir, ITC was taken, it was supposed to be used in business, you are using for personal purpose, it will be taxable now, okay? So what is written in? Yes, it is a deemed supply as per schedule 1 under section 71C. Under section 71C. Without consideration, supply without consideration. Yeah? Can I go ahead? They have given difference between 71B and 71C for importation of service. 71B, it is importation of service, consideration is mandatory, business is not mandatory, yes or no?
Yes.
And 71C, consideration is not there but business is there.
Yes.
Import of service. So summary they have written. This is the definition of related person. Hello?
Yes.
Related person means officer of the company and then directors of the company of if director is common in two companies, then those two companies will become related parties. Okay? Next. Such people are legally recognized as a partners. If they are partner, they are related person. They are employer-employee. I told you, no, employer-employee also become relative here. Okay? Controls or hold more than 25% share in business. So, if I hold 25% share, I am A Limited, I am holding 30% share in your business. Is it more than 25? Yes. So, we both are related parties. Hello? So, why related party definition is important? Because whenever you do transaction with related party without consideration, it is treated as supply. It is treated as supply. Okay? One of them is directly or indirectly controls other. Both of them are directly, indirectly is controlled by third person. Like, you are controlled by your father. Your brother is also controlled by your father. I'm not asking whether your father and you are relative. Obviously, because your father is controlling you, you are relative. Hello?
Yes.
I'm asking whether you and your brother is relative.
Yes.
You don't control brother, brother doesn't control you. You don't hold any share in each other. But still you are related. Why?
Yes.
Father is common. Yes, na? So third person is controlling both.
Yes.
So these two are related. Yes or no?
Yes.
So there is A Limited, there is a B Limited, and there is a C Limited. A Limited doesn't hold even one share in C Limited. C Limited doesn't hold any share in A Limited. But both of these companies are commonly held by B Limited. So A and C is
related
person.
Yes.
Are you getting this?
Yes.
Okay. B and A is related. C and B is also related. I'm talking about
A
and C is also related because common control is there. So third party control. Not required to go into that detail, just for your basic understanding I said. So any person controls or directly owns, directly indirectly owns more than 25% is a related party. Based on that they have taken this 30,000 shares in A Limited and 25,000 shares in B Limited. So they are asking whether it is related or not. Obviously it is related because out of 1 lakh share, 30,000 shares are held. So 30% related party. Alright. And here it is 25,000 shares out of 80,000. So again it is more than 1/4. Yes or no?
Yes.
So it is a related party. So they are just giving some examples of related party. Ravi and company, a CMA firm, employer who is represents his employee before the income tax authorities but does not charge any professional fees in respect of the same. Is it a supply? So what has happened? You are a CMA and you are having one employee. That employee got income tax notice. Hello, you are a practicing CMA. You understand income tax and GST law and all. That your employee got income tax notice. So what that employee must have said? Sir, oh, kuch nahi, income tax se ghar se notice aaya sir. You said, okay, no problem. I will go and I will handle the case. Silent it, no? I'll go and I will handle the case. Yes or no? You just said simply, I will go and handle the case. Will you charge money from your employee? It's like I'm chartered accountant and Chiju got notice from income tax department. What Chiju will come and say, sir, can you just manage this matter? I went to department, I managed the matter. Yes or no?
Yes.
And I did not charge anything from him. Hello?
Yes.
So is it a supply of service or not a supply of service? It is supply of service because employer and employee are related parties. Employer and employees are related parties, and related because it is related party, even supply without consideration as per schedule 1. It is a deemed supply. As per schedule 1, it is deemed supply. Are you getting this?
Yes.
Yeah? So it would constitute as a taxable supply under GST and subject to levy and collection of tax. Understood?
Yes.
See, this is little confusing. So you should mark this type of question. We are searching this type of question. Okay? Okay. Before going into this, we will finish up our discussion of so this is concept 4. This is section 71A now. Earlier it was 71D, now it is 71A. Schedule 2. Schedule 2 doesn't have any much implication in our life as a CMA Inter student as of now, because we are not going to discuss any litigations, any court cases. But this is the general knowledge that we have developed, that in Schedule 2 we are having activities to be treated either as supply of goods or supply of service. So this is either of supply of goods or supply of service. So it is classifying only two categories. Alright. So transfer of title of goods. Come on, tell me. Transfer of title. This is how you need to make chart. I'll teach you from module. Better I'll teach. This chart is already there with you. I wanted to show you it from it module. Okay. Chart is already there, no? Okay. On page number. Where is page number? Page number 27, I guess.
Yes.
On page number 27, this table is there. Okay. You have to tell me answer whether it is supply of goods or supply of service. Okay. Don't look at the answer. This is answer. Okay. You have to tell me whether it is supply of goods or supply of service. Okay. Transfer of title in goods. Title means I'm giving you ownership. Goods along with ownership.
Yes.
Supply of goods. So it is supply of goods. Okay. Transfer of right in goods without transfer of title. So I'm not giving you title. I'm just giving you right. Use and give it back.
No.
So it is supply of service. Okay. Then transfer of title in goods under agreement that stipulated title will be transferred in future date. Future date. Higher purchase. So this is supply of goods. Okay. Higher purchase. Now land and building. So far as land and building is concerned, I told you two things you need to remember. If you are buying land and building before CC, then GST is applicable. After CC, GST is not applicable. Before CC means before completion certificate and after completion certificate. Because before completion certificate, if you purchase flat, understand this, okay, building is like at this level, okay, it's not completed. And you book the flat here, okay, which is still about to construct. Now when builder is constructing this flat, builder is not constructing for himself. Builder is constructing flat for you.
Yes,
yes or no?
Yes.
Because you have booked under construction flat. So builder is giving you services. Builder is giving you services. But if flat is already ready, this house is already ready, everything is completed, and now you are going and buying it. Hello? It's not taxable because house is already constructed. Completion certificate is there. Now, house is constructed or not constructed is not my call. Okay, that is municipality will give you that certificate, completion certificate. GST department just saying, if you purchase flat after CC, no GST. If you purchase flat before CC, there will be GST. You know rate of GST in Mumbai? On real estate? 5%. And what is the on an average rate of flat here? 1 crore? Minimum?
Yes.
That means if you wanted to save GST of 5%, what you should do?
After CC.
Are you getting this?
Yes.
Very simple consultancy that you have to give. Do you want to pay GST? Then book flat under construction. If you wanted to save GST, then buy flat after construction. But problem is that before construction, builder will offer flat at little discounted price. After construction, builder will increase price. But that's okay. Why? Because so many projects are in Mumbai are still pending. Their completion was supposed to be in 2016-2017. This is 2019. Still projects are not completed. So isn't it risky to put money into under construction building?
Yes.
Risky. So to save two things. What? One is that pain of waiting for construction to be completed, that you can directly purchase a ready to move flat. So that pain is not there, that uncertainty is not there. Second benefit is that you can save 5% GST. Yes or no? Alright, if you buy constructed flat. Okay. Sir, so what is this here, land and building, sir? So land and building here means, okay, first of all, lease, tenancy and land and building. Building bhaade pe dena, lease pe dena is what? Supply of goods or supply of service? Supply of service. Because you are not taking building and going anywhere, you are taking it on lease. So that is service. Okay. Lease, letting of building, including for business, that is okay. Leasing and renting is only there. That is supply of service. Then treatment and process. Treatment and process. Understand this also. You are Raymond India or you are Peter England or you are Arrow, you are a shirt manufacturing company. So you manufacture whole shirt, okay. But for putting this button, you come to me. Okay, I'm a job worker. Do you understand job worker? So what will you give me? You will give me shirt and you will give me button. You will give me thread also, matching thread. What is my job? My job is to put these buttons and then stitch it. Maybe manually or maybe by using machine. Hello? But this facility, you don't do it. Yes or no? So you gave me shirt and button separately and thread separately. My job is to put it here and give it back.
Yes.
You understand my job? What am I giving you?
Service
or goods?
Service.
But what are you taking from my shop? Are you taking, getting this? Technically, you are taking shirts from my shop. But that shirt, I am not selling you. That shirt you only gave me. I just put some labor work on this and I'm giving it back. Yes or no? So treatment and process is what?
Service.
Service or sale?
Service.
Supply of goods or supply of service?
Service.
Service. Supply of service. You brought this laptop to me for repair. I repaired and I'm giving you laptop back. If you look at physically, I'm giving you laptop. Physically, I'm giving you laptop, but actually I'm providing you
service.
Okay? Permanent transfer or disposal of business. We have just discussed 7-1-C. Yeah? So it is what? AC. You are taking this AC to home. It is supply of service or supply of goods?
Goods.
Supply of goods. Okay. Then, if I give this laptop to my brother for use. Hello? And today income tax department or GST department raided my premises and said, sir, you had laptop. One laptop is not there in business. If I say permanently transfer, that means deemed supply. So what will I lie? Arre sir, it is there at my home, I will just go and bring it. This manipulation people will do, you know. If department comes and says, you need to have 3 ACs here, 1 AC is missing, it is in my home. I'll say, sir, it's not, oh, ghar pe thode din ke liye lekar gaya tha, sir. Hello? Only few days. It's not permanent transfer. If it was permanent transfer, I would have paid tax. It's not permanent transfer. It's just a temporary transfer, only for a few days. You give me 5-6 days, I will bring that AC back to the office and I'll put it here. Hello?
Yes.
People can say this, no? So what government said? Permanent transfer is supply of goods and temporary transfer is supply of service. So, and in GST law both are taxable. You say it goods, still it is taxable. You say it service, still it is taxable. So you understand this? So if it is permanent transfer or disposal, it is supply of goods. If it is temporary transfer, allowing use means you understand? Temporary transfer, then it is supply of service. Okay? You had a registration, you took goods, you took ITC, and then you are closing down your business. You are shutting down your business. Hello? You did not sell goods. Goods are still there in shop. You are shutting down it. Government will assume it is supply of goods. Why? You have taken ITC and now you are closing down your business. That means you will not pay output tax. Yes or no? You will not pay output tax. Therefore, government will assume today only on date of closing down the business, we will assume all these goods are supplied without consideration and taxable. It is taxable. But this clause is not applicable to amalgamation. This clause is not applicable to? Why in amalgamation what happens? A limited is gone, but B limited will take over business and carry on the business. Business is not closed down. Only ownership has changed. Yes. Hello, and there are provisions in my GST law which allow transfer of credit from A limited to B limited in case of amalgamation. Am I clear?
Yes.
Hello, so this is how it is written there. Not that important. Let's go ahead. Renting of immobile property. Tell me, renting of immobile property, service or
service?
But I told you that residential building is exempt.
Yes.
Okay, residential building for residential purpose is exempt. Construction. Okay, now I'm reading whole paragraph for you guys so that this construction, so far basic idea should be clear. Before CCN, after CCN, because construction comes in two schedule. Schedule 2 also it is there and schedule 3 also it is there.
Yes.
Schedule 3 means negatively, that means no GST.
Yes.
Schedule 2 means either supply of goods or supply of service, that means yes GST.
Yes.
Hello. So items which are there in schedule 2, it is taxable under GST.
Yes.
And items which are there in schedule 3 are not taxable in GST. Yes or no? And construction is in both schedule 2 as well as schedule 3. So it is very obvious for a student to get confused. Alright, so let me talk about it. I am reading line by line para. First of all, I am reading which para? Entry number 5B. This we will refer in schedule 3. Entry number 5B. What is there in entry number 5B? Construction of complex building, civil structure or part thereof, including a complex or building intended for sale to a buyer, wholly or partly. So here, till now, if you read up to here, construction is what? In construction, I use bricks, cement, steel, rod. Hello? And I put my labor also, labor, architect, service also. So I have to classify either one of it, supply of goods or supply of service. You classify. Construction is what? Supply of goods or supply of service? No, it is both, but we have to classify one.
Service.
Supply of service. So they are saying it is supply of service. You understood?
Yes.
So they are saying construction is the supply of service. Am I clear?
Yes.
Construction activities are supply of service. But then they are saying except. Except means what? It will not be called as service. Hello? Except means in certain situation it will not be called as service. Normally construction is service. In which case it will be not be called as service? Where entire consideration has been received after issuance of completion certificate. Whole consideration means 100% money is received after completion certificate. That means building is already constructed and now you are going and buying flat, then it is not service. Hello?
Yes,
if you are going buying after completion, it is not a service. So you tell me, before CC, GST applicable or not applicable? Before CC, applicable because it is service. After CC, because it is covered under schedule 3.
Yes.
Schedule 2 before CC, schedule 3 after CC, schedule 2 taxable, schedule 3 not taxable. Am I clear?
Yes.
This is just a game. before CC, after CC. Under construction building, it is covered by schedule 2, taxable. Under construction building, covered by schedule 2, taxable. Yes or no?
Yes.
Building constructed, CC obtained, covered by schedule 3, not taxable. Should I repeat again? I said it for 4 or 5 times, I guess.
Yes.
In building case, only simple thing is there, CC. Before CC, it is covered under schedule 2. Schedule 2 is supply of service. Taxable or not taxable?
Taxable.
Taxable. Okay. After CC, it is covered by schedule 3. This is negative list, not taxable. Baat clear hai?
Yes.
Okay. Now they are adding one more word. We are required by the competent authority after his first occupation, whichever is earlier. Sometime what happens, some government doesn't give CC. Some area there is no concept of completion certificate. But then occupation will happen. What will happen? Occupation. That means people will go and start staying in the flat. You tell me, CC certificate is not given by government, but people have started staying in the flat. That means flat is complete or incomplete? Huh? Complete or incomplete? People are staying there. They are hanging their clothes and all. Obviously, it is almost complete. So they are saying either completion certificate or occupancy, whichever is earlier. So that event they are just creating. Major event is completion certificate, but legally they are saying it is completion certificate or date of occupancy, whichever is earlier. That means if I am giving you certificate, flat is ready. Yes or no? If I am giving you certificate, completion, that means flat is ready. And secondly, if you are staying in the flat without certificate, still flat is ready. If you started staying in the flat, that means flat is ready or not ready?
Ready.
Ready. You understand? So they say completion certificate or occupancy, whichever is earlier. But we will always refer it with the reference of CC. Majorly we refer it with the reference of CC. Okay. So this is how it is. Next. Temporary transfer or permitting use. Not permanent transfer, temporary transfer or permitting use. So I develop one software, I am allowing you to use my software, and for that I will take some money, license. I give you license to use my software. What it is?
Service.
Service. Obviously it is service. Okay. This word you remember that DD,
yes.
PC.
Yes.
So development, designing, programming, customization, adaptation, upgradation, enhancement, implementation of information technology software. Can you tell me 2-3 names of IT companies in India? They're famous.
Infosys.
Microsoft.
India. Microsoft is US based company, right answer, but US based. Indian. Infosys, TCS, Wipro. Yes or no? Mitas. So these are companies. Satyam, not Mitas. Satyam Computers. Right, some scam happened few years back. So these are the companies in India. What is their job? What is their business? Supply of goods or supply of service? So Infosys is a service sector company or? Why? Because what Infosys does? Development, designing, programming, customization, adaptation, upgradation, enhancement and implementation of IT software. So they are selling IT software. So they are into service or they are into goods?
Service.
Very easy. Okay. Next. Agreeing for to the obligation or refraining from act. This I already told you. Kuch nahi karna bhi kuch karna hota hai. So kya? Supply of goods or supply of service? Supply of service. Okay. Refraining from act. Then for cash or deferred payment for valuable consideration. Transfer of right to use any goods. Transfer of right to use goods. Use goods. Use means?
Service.
Service. No. I am giving you goods to use. Not to own. Use and give it back.
Yes.
Supply of?
Service.
Service. Okay. Composite supply. Composite supply, you understand? Composite means there are material and labor. Composite means what? There is a material plus labor. In hotel, I told you, no?
Yes.
There will be food plus service. So, food plus service. But we have to classify one.
Yes.
So supply of goods or supply of service?
Service.
Service. Work contract, bike mechanic, construction service. Okay. So this is how it is there. I hope you understood it.
Yes.
Goods and services. This is the classification. Apart from this, I want you people.